A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 27th Jan, on the front page you have India showcases ASAT missile prowess. So on the Republic Day parade, India showcased its anti-satellite missile capability to the world as this weapon, which is developed, this weapon is called Mission Shakti. So developed by WDRDO, it was rolled out at Rajpath during the 71st Republic Day parade. So here you can see this is the anti-satellite missile system, Mission Shakti. Also, Chinook heavy lift helicopter and Apache attack helicopters made their debut during the Republic Day flypast this year. Then this is fund crunch hits MGNREGA scheme. So 96% of annual allocation has exhausted, and now there is not enough amount to pay because there is increase in demand for MGNREGA work and the amount spent has overshot the budget. So this is for specifically for Rajasthan too. You can see Rajasthan, UP deficit is more than 300 crores now. So Rajasthan, the amount spent has overshot the budget by 600 crores. So that is the problem here. So center is on the verge of running out funds for MGNREGA. Then below you have European Union Parliament set to vote on Kashmir Citizenship Amendment Act. So six resolutions will be taken up by the European Union Parliament for discussion this week. So you should know about it. They are going to vote on this matter. And this is, it's a long road to joy for these adopted children. So this is regarding adopted children and how if mismatch happens in expectations, then this leads to traumatic parting with parents. So the child is separated from the parents. There's this example of a child who had spent varying periods with three families and then returned. So center has now launched a remedial plan. There's the Central Adoption Resource Authority, which has which is the apex body in this matter. So it has begun a nationwide capacity building program for social workers who help assess the suitability of the adopted family and prepare the child for a new home. So adjustment problems are seen for which is, matching expectations program has been launched. On page 4 you have cases of diabetes and cancer rise in rural areas of Madhya Pradesh. So non-communicable diseases like hypertension, diabetes and cancer are posing a bigger challenge in the non-tribal rural areas of Madhya Pradesh than in urban areas. And this is due to rapidly growing rate of incidence and the lack of awareness here. So that has been seen. So now steps have been taken under the National Health Mission. So screening of people has been started. So you have the central government's non-communicable disease control program. So it has been seen low incidence in tribal blocks in the state, which is actually the largest tribal population in the country. So largest tribal population in the country is in Madhya Pradesh, and there is higher incidence in non-tribal areas than in urban, non-tribal rural areas than in urban areas. Also, a reason for high incidence in rural areas is given. You can see it is said trans fatty acids when consumed in hydrogenated form is a major cause of hypertension or high blood pressure, and cooking oil being reused results in trans fatty acids. So this is still being done, cooking oil being reused for the purpose in several rural areas, which is causing high incidence of these non-communicable diseases in rural areas than in urban areas. So one of the reasons is also given. So of the countries, 100 districts with the highest prevalence of hypertension, 15 districts are from Madhya Pradesh. On page 7 you have villagers use Gram Sabhas to oppose projects. So villagers in different parts of Tamil Nadu are using Gram Sabha meetings organized on Republic Day to pass resolutions against initiatives such as hydrocarbon exploration and even India-based neutrino observatory, INO project, which has been proposed in the state. So they fear this would be detrimental to their respective regions. So we had seen about hydrocarbon exploration also, how government had relaxed regulations environment clearance regulations. Even Tamil Nadu government wrote to the Prime Minister asking for changes here. And now here you can see people are also protesting against it. Then this is districts in Manipur may be named after fruits. So Manipur Chief Minister has said government was planning to name districts after specific local fruits and species. So Manipur has 16 districts, 5 in central Imphal Valley and rest are in the hills around. So each district is known for a specific variety of fruit or herb. So such plans give each district a unique identity and they are planning to name them after these fruits and other special plants. And this is ANSI explores the anthropologist Gandhi on his 150th birth anniversary. So Anthropological Survey of India dedicated an issue of its journal to Gandhian insights into applied anthropology on 150th birth anniversary of Mahatma Gandhi in 2019. So India actually has planned to celebrate 150th birth anniversary of Mahatma Gandhi from 2nd October 2018 to 2nd October 2020. So that is the time frame, 2 years. On editorial page, the first editorial is black and grey. So this is regarding FATF, Financial Action Task Force. The plenary meet would take place and it would be decided whether Pakistan should be continued in the grey listing and or whether it should be moved to blacklist or should be removed from grey list. So a decision will be taken, and you should know Financial Action Task Force has put Pakistan in grey list because of terror financing. So basically FATF looks into terror financing and money laundering issues internationally. So India must be conscious of the geopolitics behind Pakistan's relative success at FATF is what is being spoken of. So in Beijing, at the Asia Pacific group of FATF, Pakistan, the meetings, the discussions have given Pakistan some encouraging news that it had progressed in its efforts to avoid a blacklisting. And now final decision will be taken at the plenary meeting only, but the indication given is positive. So Pakistan, what would be the final decision, we'll come to know. It's a 39-member FATF which would decide on this matter. But there are countries which are supporting Pakistan, especially China. So that is known. And below you have dubious decision. So this is regarding National Investigation Agency's takeover of Bhima Koregaon probe. So it is said this is a ploy to perpetuate urban Naxal narrative. So that is what Home Ministry has decided to transfer the investigation in Bhima Koregaon case in Maharashtra to NIA. Because it is unwarranted interference in the police powers of the state. And it is clearly aimed at preventing the new regime in Maharashtra from reviewing the controversial probe done under BJP-led government through SIT of its own. So now that case has been gone to the center because we have Maharashtra Aghadi, Vikas Aghadi coalition government in Maharashtra, which would have reviewed the earlier decisions. So now it has gone into the Central Investigation Agency, NIA, which clearly shows politicization of NIA too. Then the lead article is At the Heart of the Republic. So this article talks about how India's Republican heart fares well and beats to love, confidence and liberty. So the 71st Republic Day was celebrated by all, so that shows how India still beats for love, confidence, freedom. And this is the four phases of constitutional interpretation. So this talks about how judiciary is beginning to interpret the constitution in line with its revolutionary and transformative potential. So this talks about the entire history of how the Supreme Court has evolved in interpreting the constitution. On the op-ed page, you have deriving authority from we the people. So it's again about understanding the constitution around the preamble. So, and this is the hype over hypersonics. So this talks about Russia, which has announced its new hypersonic glide vehicle, Avangard, which will be launched atop an intercontinental ballistic missile. So this has been made operational now, and Russia claims that this nuclear armed Hypersonic glide vehicle can fly at over 20 times the speed of sound and is capable of such maneuvers as to be invulnerable to interception by any existing and prospective missile defense means to systems to. So this means potential of potential adversaries, that missile defense would also not work. So such a hypersonic glide vehicle has been developed by Russia. So, induction would likely be a transitory advantage, because eventually leading nations it will lead nations into a strategic trap. So, because this is about deterrence. If one country develops something, other countries would also go ahead and build those capabilities. On page 11, you have religious themes run through tableaux. So, this is regarding the Republic Day parade. So, this showcased the even 10 of the 15 displays, it says, carried religious themes. So, here you can see this is the tableau of Assam rolled out. So, this tableau also, and also Punjab based its tableau on the 550th birth anniversary of Guru Nanak and his principles. Karnataka's display was on philosophy of Basaveshwara and his Anubhav Mantapa, an ancient sociologist center. UP's tableau centered on cultural and religious tourism with a replica of even Deva Sharif Sufi shrine. On international page, here you have regarding China taking steps to control the virus, but the virus is getting stronger now. It is spreading. And UN says blatant violation of Libya arms embargo continues. So, United Nations has decried continued blatant violations by several countries of an arms embargo on in Libya. So, UN support mission in Libya didn't name any specific nations but said they included several who participated in the Berlin conference. So, in Germany, in Berlin, we had a conference on both sides, the Haftar side and the UN recognized government side in Libya, and countries supporting them had pledged to put an arms embargo and end foreign meddling, but it still continues. And here you have Palestinians threatened to quit Oslo Accord. So, Palestinian officials have threatened to withdraw from key provisions of the Oslo Accord, which define relations of Palestine with Israel. So, they said this will quit the accord if US President Donald Trump announces his West Asia peace plan next week. So, Trump's initiative will turn Israel's temporary occupation of Palestinian territory into a permanent occupation, is what is the fear. Then on Mondays on business page, you have this money-wise coverage. So, that can be skipped. So, these are the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website, asha.com. Thank you.